This story takes place in a fictional Greek island of Kolokari. Donna is a single mother who spent her life like a hippie in her younger days with her band Donna and the Dynamos, but now has settled in this Greek island and runs a hotel, Villa Donna, her villa which she has turned into a hotel. She is preparing for her daughter's wedding with the help of two old friends and former Dynamo bandmates, Rosie and Tanya. Meanwhile, Sophie, Donna's daughter and the bride-to-be, has chanced upon a mother's diary and finds out that a mother had three men in her life: Sam Carmichael, Bill Anderson, and Harry Bright. Sophie does not know who her father is, so she secretly invites all the three men from her mother's past in hope of meeting her real father, as she wants her father to walk her down the aisle on her wedding day. She tells this secret to her friends Ali and Lisa. Sophie believes that she will know which one is her father when she sees them, but when she does, she is confused and can't figure out which one is her father. Donna gets a shock of her life when she sees Sam, Bill, and Harry in her hotel on the eve of her daughter's wedding. She is upset and anxious lest Sophie should find out. What happens next? Sit back and enjoy. Watch how the drama escalates and comes into a surprisingly humorous ending.
A dream, a song to sing, to help me cope with anything. If you see the wonder of a fairy, you can take the future.
Even if you fail, Sam Carmichael, Bill Anderson, and Harry Bright.
Nearly kills me, aha, honey, honey. I've heard about
some more.
Wanted to know some more.
And now I know what they mean. He's a love machine. Oh, he makes me dizzy.
A love machine? That's nothing.
Honey, honey, let me feel it. The way that you kiss goodnight,
the way that you hold me
tight, I feel like I want to sing when you do your
thing. So the guy sang to your dad.
The blood thickens. Sam told Mom he was going home to get married.
August 4th. What a night.
I was still feeling depressed about Sam,
Jack and Jack.
When after the show,
Bill rented a motor boat,
and I took him over to the little island.
One thing led to another, and dot dot dot.
Bill! August 15th.
What a night.
Hammond starts up out of the blue. So I said, I'd show him the little island. I must need my head examined. But he was so sweet, I couldn't help but ask.
Dot dot dot.
Well, three names. Sam, Bill, or Harry.
And they're all arriving for the wedding?
Yes.
We know.
What do you write to a total stranger? Come to my wedding? He might be my dad? No. I think Mom sent the invitations. And after what's sitting here, I'm not surprised. This is the end.
Honey, honey, touch me, baby.
Sooner or later.
I'm not having Mom frighten them off before I've even got to know them. And with any luck, I'll know my dad straight away.
And what if we don't?
Then I've got 24 hours to find out.
Honey, honey, how he told me.
Step in the sorting heels.
What do you expect? A chauffeured limousine at the water's edge?
Well, yes, Donna knows I don't do walking.
Well, look what the tide's washed in. Pay for one night and one night only. It's Donna and the Dynamos!
Look at you!
You look fantastic!
And you look like an old hippie.
So, how's the mother of the bride?
All better after seeing you bare. God, Tanya, 8 long years. Well, I've been chained to this place and have constant battle with my bank manager.
I pity the poor bank manager. Auntie Rosie.
Sophie Sheridan.
You get more gorgeous every time I see you.
Well, don't I get a big fat kiss for coming all this way for your wedding?
I bet you don't remember me.
All that plastic surgery.
Of course I did. I keep
Tanya. Oh, look at my baby. She has her whole life ahead of her.
Oh, Mom. I'm getting married, not joining your convent.
Well, in my days, they didn't get married at 20.
No, in our days, they did not get married. Full stop.
A white wedding. I don't know where she gets it from.
Don't blame me, Donna. It wasn't my idea.
Girls, meet the leading man. Sky, Rosie, and Tanya. My one-time backing band and all good time mates.
Hey, backing band. Hello.
Hi, I bought what's about you?
All bad, I hope. Donna, the taverner looks... Oh, we've got Sky to thank for that. What? You've not been here long, have you?
No, I came here escape from the London Stock Exchange, and I never went back.
Why?
I'd burnt out. I'd been dealing in the world, but you'd never know.
But you should see what he's done to my world. He's gotten me online. You email wired up and knuckled down.
Gotta move with the times, Donna.
Yeah, just invent me a machine that'll make the beds.
You'd still run behind it and do it all again.
I know you. Are you joking? I'd more than ready to put my feet up when the boat comes in.
Well, talking of boats, I sink that old drink you've got moored by the jetty.
Sink it?
Well, it's a bit of an eyesore.
Well, that eyesore is going to be my floating casino.
What?
Sky is transforming it into a millionaire's paradise.
Sailing around the islands, gambling under the stars.
Gambling millionaires? There might be a few of your ex-husbands abroad, Tanya.
Don't think so, darling. Didn't leave them their millions.
Well, this is going to be my jackpot, girls. I need a break. I need a holiday. I've been running this place for 15 years and I've never had a day off.
Where's everybody? Oh.
Good afternoon. Can I I'm Bill Anderson. You have a room for me?
Bill Anderson?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry, so you must be...
Sam Carmichael. Yeah. Were you expecting us?
Yes. Yes, of course. I'll get the keys.
Well, I hope I get the chance to get my tongue around a little Greek.
Oh, yeah?
I haven't spoken it for 21 years.
Hang on.
21 years? You know, this is beginning to sound a bit like a setup. Well, now, Bill, here's a story for you. Friends, three men, strangers, receive an invitation to bed. They're invited to a place they haven't visited for 21 years by a woman they haven't seen for 21 years. Why are they here?
That's not bad. Harry, what's your excuse? What's torn you away from the Bank of England?
Is this an interview? Well, for me, Donna's invitation brought back many happy memories.
Nora! Is that a boat?
I know this guitar. HB, Headbanger. That's what they called me in those days. And DS, Donna Sheridan. I bought this for her. Donna knew my wild side. I was on my sixth form trip to Paris and I just followed her to peace. Hang on. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. We used to sing this one. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty. What would life be without a song or a dance? What are we? So I say thank you for the music, for giving it to me. You are Donna's daughter.
Yes.
I thought she looked familiar. So you're Sophia.
It's just Sophie.
Well, so pretty. I had a great aunt, Sophia.
I'm named after Sophia.
Where is Donna? I want to see her. I want to thank her for the invitation.
Yes, it's very kind of her to remember us.
No, you mustn't. Your secret. I send the invitations. She doesn't know.
Why?
Because Mom's always talking about our friends from the old days, and I thought she'd just be thrilled if I invited you all. But then she's got herself in such a state about this wedding, and she's not expecting guests, and she'll have her friends late.
So she's... Hold on. Are you trying to tell us that Donna didn't invite us?
No. So just pretend you're here for a holiday, and she'll get a lovely surprise when she sees you all at my wedding. We'll let her win on the secret.
Yes, but...
Mother says I was a dancer before I could walk. She says I began to sing long before. Golden hair, I wanna sing
Not really here.
Would you like me to pinch you?
You keep your hands to yourself.
You've changed your tune.
What are you doing here, Sam? Why are any of you here? Sorry, I'm just amazed to see you all.
Well, I'm doing an article for a magazine.
And I'm here for a spontaneous holiday. And I thought I would just drop in and say hi.
Shame. We don't have any rooms. It's that time of the year.
Just as well, I booked ahead.
Well, this is so inconvenient.
Why?
Because one of the local girls is getting married tomorrow. And I just don't have the staff to cope with you all. You'd be much more comfortable on the mainland.
Oh no, not at all. Bill here's used to roughing it. And the old headbanger over the last word in spontaneous.
What about you?
Me? Well, I came back to see the island and...
Well, I'd love to stop and chat and chew over old times. But I have to go.
Age does not wither her.
I was expecting a rather stout matron. No, she's still Donna.
Thank you. tonight for the end party.
I had to let out those seams first.
Where's Sophie?
I haven't seen her. Why?
I must find her now.
Ta-da!
Oh God, that's all I want.
It was in the trunk.
You should hang it in the bar. Show Sophie what a funky mom she's got.
No, give it here. Burn it. I never want to see it again.
What's up?
Yo, what happened? This has to be a joke. Any minute I'm gonna wake up and they'll all have gone away.
What if?
Nothing. Just leave me alone. I can't talk about it. I knew this would happen. Of course, it had to. It had to come out now. Oh God, why was I so stupid?
Chickadita, tell me what's wrong. I have never seen so sorrow.
Who ran home to get married.
Typical man.
Well, I'm not really sure it was him. You see, there were a couple of others.
Donna Sheridan!
Why didn't you tell us?
I didn't think I'd ever have to. I didn't think all three would be in front of my bar the day before my daughter's wedding.
What? In the bar? Let me see them. I can't see anyone. Where are they?
Donna, are you sure?
Of course I am.
You think I forget my daughter's dad? Sam, Bill Atchison, and Tally Headbanger. Why have they all turned up now with some horrible trick of fate?
Gods, it's very quick.
Do they know?
No, I never told anyone. I mean, why are they here ruining Sophie's wedding?
I thought you weren't keen on this wedding.
I won't let them spoil things. They have no right to turn up like this. I mean, what have they ever done to their daughter?
Donna, be fair. They did not even know she existed.
They don't need to know. I have done a good job by raising Sophie all by myself and now...
Look, tonight's a May-free zone at the handstand, and then tomorrow, Tanya and I will take them fishing.
Fishing? Oh, please. Oh, I suppose this just about serves me right.
Oh God, you sound just like your mother.
I do not.
You do.
Whatever.
whatever happened to Donna the life and soul of the party?
And their antic supremo.
Oh, she grew up.
That's all.
Well, go back down again. Done fishing.
I was sick and tired of everything. so much tonight. Tonight the super trooper lights are gonna find me, shining like the sun.
Her name was Sophia.
My great aunt Sophia?
I think it must be.
Well, I always heard her money went to family. Wait a minute, how old are you?
I'm 20. Why did great aunt leave my mother that money?
I don't know.
You do, please. Just tell me.
Well, what has your mother said?
She won't talk about the past. She doesn't understand, but I need to know.
Well, you'll have to speak to her.
This has got nothing to do with her. My whole life has been one big unanswered question, and I don't want any more secrecy.
Sophie, this hasn't been my secret.
Well, you know what comes next?
Don't tell me I have a twin sister.
Will you give me away?
Give you away?
I'll feel like a proper bride if I can walk down the aisle with my father.
Well then, I'll find your mother then.
No, not tonight. We'll keep this our secret till the wedding.
She'll go crazy.
She'll be relieved. She'll see us together and see them happy.
Oh, all right. I'll do it.
Across the room, your eyes are glowing in the dark.
I won't beat around the bush. I know why I'm here. And let me tell you, I think it's brilliant. I've always wanted a little girl, and the big ones even better.
No, Samus.
I know I'm rushing things, but just tell me, does your mother know what I know?
No, she.
Good, good. Listen, who's giving away?
No one.
Wrong. I am.
You.
Yes.
Oh.
And don't worry about Donna. She doesn't scare me much.
And here we go again. Don't start, we know the end.
Down the aisle. Well, I'm not gonna let you down. I'll be there.
What happened to our love? It used to be so good.
absolutely none of your business.
And what's the sky? Is it good enough for her?
And that's none of your business either.
So will you hear me, darling? Can't you hear me? Yes, so hey. The love you gave me, nothing else can save me. Yes, so hey.
Thank you. That was the tenth of the flower power. Underneath, we had a fear of flying, of going home, a fear of slowly dying. We took our chance, like we were dancing our last dance. I can still recall.
Sophie? That's the dress then.
Yes.
So, are Ali and Lisa ready to help you?
Mom, will you help me?
School bag in hand, she leaves home in the early morning, waving goodbye with an absent-minded smile. I watch her go with a search of that well-known sadness, and I have to sit down for a while. The feeling that I'm losing her forever, and without reason
precious time go by.
well. Some of that we did, but most we didn't. And why, I just don't know.
Sophie tells me you're giving her away.
Yes, I am, Wills.
What about her dad?
Her dad isn't here.
It's what she wants. She told me she wants her father to be here. Maybe her father wants her as well.
What? Don't you do this to me now, Sam. I can't hear this now.
Donna, listen. This is about us.
seated. Especially to Donna, who represents your family. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of God.
And welcome to Sophie's dad. I have to tell you, it isn't fair to keep it from you any longer. He's here.
I know. I'm ready.
But you can't have, I don't know which one of them it is. Oh my God, that's why they're all here. Oh, I don't know, Sophie. Will you ever forgive me?
You're my mom.
Hold on. Are we saying that I might be Sophie's dad, but it might be Bill or even Harry?
You've got it, and you've got yourself to blame for that.
I what?
Yes, if you haven't gone off and met someone else.
No, it wasn't like that. I was engaged. I had to go home. I thought it was the right thing to do, but I came back.
What?
Yeah. I told Lorraine I couldn't marry her, and I came straight back.
Well, why didn't you call me then?
Because I was sure that you would be waiting for me. Only when I got here, they told me you'd gone off. So, I went back to Lorraine, who told me what an idiot I was. Married me to prove it. I'm sorry. I might come in for a minute, or a moment. There's something.
Oh, Harry, the chair. I'm sorry.
Oh no, stop the chair. It's yours. It's just great to even have a thought of Sophie. I never thought I'd get that much of a child.
Oh, Harry.
Donna, you're the first girl that I've ever loved, but you're also the last girl. There are all kinds of families, aren't there? Yours is you, and Sophie, mine is me, and Lawrence. Well, look, he's right. We can find out if you want to. But I agree with Harry. Being a third of a dad is great, man. And me too.
All right, let's come together.
I don't know which one of you is my dad, but I don't mind. I've learned something about myself. Sky, let's not get married. I knew you never wanted any of this anyway, okay? I've got my whole life ahead of me. Let's just get out of this island and get out the world.
I love
you. Donna, I take it the wedding is cancelled?
I haven't got a clue what's going on.
Now hold on. Why waste a good wedding? How about it, Sheridan? You're going to need somebody to boss around the island of yours.
I am not.
I'm a divorced man who loved you for 21 years. And ever since I got on this island, I've been bursting to show you how much. Come on, Don. I'll see you the rest of your life.
You love me, don't deny.
Say I
awful fairy tale. You can take the future, even if you fail. I believe in angels, something good in everything I see.
Chetri. Put your hands together for our choir and for our musicians.
From last 3 days, thank you so much, those parents too. have to thank, of course, I said so, supportive parent. I've got a gentleman over here, a parent who is playing the pad. So please. So, two supporting parents we have. I'd like to thank our music teachers, Mr. Sasank and Mr. Dhirendra. So, they are here. I'd like to thank, he's been always with Gyanoday. Every time it is Palash who's playing the bass. What is this? And I've got four of these boys who I want them up. They are playing over here. It is Pius playing the drums. Please come up. Electric guitar, Abhinav. Come in the front. You have to stay there. And acoustic guitar, Raj Prajwal D. And the smallest of them lot, this guy playing the keyboard is Penan. Yesterday also I forgot to mention one name. He's been helping us in the backstage. Doing the props. It is Rakesh. So Rakesh, please come over here. Rakesh, if you are here. Not here. Okay. He's not here. Anyway. I'd like to thank for the costumes, Ms. Suzata, please come. Come over here. And props team, if Rakesh is not there, others are there, so if you could come. Back is to Anjana, Miss Anjana, Pema, Ronika and others. Please join me. Our technical team is up there, so I don't think they can come down. They are Rahul sir and Rahul sir and Rajesh sir. And Chitesh sir, the stage manager, is looking after the lights over there. This music which you heard is directed by, everything is managed and directed by our own headmaster, Mr. Devin Kurum. Please come. He is assisted by Dicky, Miss Dicky, please come. And of course, I'd like to thank you know, the choreographer of this show, the co-director. She's been directing the play also. She's been there designing the costumes also, Miss Sailika. She's the co-director and the choreographer. So all the dancers which you saw is choreographed by her. And of course, but not the least, I must thank our principal who's always supporting, and she is the one responsible for this event. So thank you so much. Ms. Deepika, our principal, please come on stage. So, I'd like to thank all of you for being here with us once more, for spending your precious time with our children, supporting them. So, thank you all. Thank you very much.
just one.